Go.
Ready?
So, really heterogeneous for a long time between the two political parties. There were plenty of anti-abortion Democrats, and there were lots of pro-choice Republicans. Republican governors were at the forefront of decriminalizing abortion in the states in the 1960s, including the governor of California, a man named Ronald Reagan. In 1967, Ronald Reagan signed into law the most liberal abortion rights bill in the country, in California. So it's not that there was not disagreement over abortion, or that there weren't strong feelings from various quarters about Roe versus Wade, but it was different. It specifically wasn't really a politics issue. It wasn't an issue that swayed elections, or that was a key part of the two parties' political platforms. Contrary to popular belief, Roe versus Wade in 1973 did not spark some kind of immediate big backlash among conservatives and evangelicals and Republicans. It evolved differently. And it's important to know that today. The anti-abortion movement as an explicitly political project, a movement married to the Republican Party, that had to be deliberately created. It did not organically emerge, and it actually did not happen until years after Roe was decided. I mean, the influential right-wing pro-segregation religious leader, Jerry Falwell, his first anti-abortion sermon was not until 1978.